He's not here. He's just on his way up now. I can see him. He's just on his way up from the pitch right now. I'll get him to talk when he's up here.
No, nothing.
Hi there, how you doing, Sound? Hi, Jack. Yeah, everything's good this end. You too. Don't have too much fun in there.
Thank you.
Welcome along to day 9 of 14 here at the Rabobank Hockey World Cup. It's the last pool game for both New Zealand and Australia, and what a thriller it's going to be. Both sets of fans taking their place ahead of this game. Slightly more Aussies in the house. Made that long journey across the water to The Hague here in Europe. And they've certainly made an effort dressing up as well. Thanks for that. Here's a look at Pool A and how things stand as we approach the final pool game. Netherlands top the table, the only unbeaten side in the pool. Australia, well, they're on 9 points. A win here will carry them through to the semi-final stages as well. A top two position essential. That's what the crowd expects. For New Zealand, well, they're ranked just behind Australia in the world rankings, fifth, Australia fourth. And here come both sides now. New Zealand led out by Kayla Whitelock. Another glorious morning here, aiming for about a 10:30 pushback once we get through the national anthems local time. So the Black Stick fans to their feet to meet and greet their team. Fans of Casey Easton in there as well. She certainly is. Nice get up, guys. Nice get up. Looking good. Well, expect this one to be a fierce contest between the two neighbours from Oceania.
Ladies and gentlemen, may I ask you to please all rise for both national anthems.
Australia looking to advance to the semi-final stages. A win here 100% confirms that. Their opponents today, New Zealand. Here's how New Zealand line up. Whitelock, the captain, Naylor, Ferguson, Glynn, Rutherford, Charlton, Cox, Dennison, Flynn, Mickelson and Punt. We know that Rose Kettle sustained a broken thumb, but she is on the bench for Mark Hague, the number 24, that in the last game against Japan. So currently sat in fourth place on 6 points, New Zealand. Let's have a little listen into the huddle.
Do the hard yards, do the basics well. Do this for each other. Do this for the group back home. This is our time to try. Let's go. Kiwis on 3, 1, 2, 3, Kiwis!
A word for the group back home. A much larger squad condensed down to the final few that travelled out to the Netherlands to represent their country. They face Australia today, who line up with Eastham, Kenny, Nelson, Anna Flanagan, McMahon, Blythe, the captain, Bone, White, Parker, Smith, and Rachel Lynch in goal for Australia. Currently ranked second in the pool as Parker takes her place. She'll be playing up front for Adam Commons today, the number 19, Georgie Parker. 100 caps too for Kate Jenner. Our two umpires, a look at them there, Chico Soma and Amy Baxter. That concluding the lineups. Beautiful sunny morning here in The Hague. Settle back, enjoy this one with us. It's Ferguson to get us underway for New Zealand. New Zealand versus Australia, the final pool game. Match 25 of the tournament and the girls' half of the tournament. Men and the women both in action here. The Australian men face India in the second game of the day. Right now, though, it's the hockey ruse we focus on. This all-important game against the Black Sticks, a win essential if Australia are going to go forward to the semi-final stages. Netherlands also in this pool with New Zealand, Australia, Korea, Japan, and Belgium. Okay. Black Sticks in possession here, but deep in their own half. Australia putting on a high press. That's come up off the foot there of Emily Smith. Two balls on the pitch. Slight delay there. I'll bring in Chloe Rogers, our colour commentator for today. Chloe, good to have you on board. Lovely day for it. And an all-important game for both sides.
Yeah, extremely important game for both teams here. And they probably know each other pretty well from having played a lot. As we see a chance, just didn't quite trap it in the circle there for Australia. But, yeah, they know each other pretty well from Oceania clashes. And I'm sure they play against each other, being so close in their rivalry and down under there. But certainly, yeah, it's going to be a good match. The both teams seem to be playing pretty well and having have their good results along the way. It should be a close one.
Yeah, New Zealand losing out to Australia in the final of the Oceania Cup this year. New Zealand qualifying by finishing fourth at the Rabobank Hockey World League in the semi-finals in 2013. Here's Cox coming forward now. And the Black Sticks now with Ferguson down that left-hand flank. Looks to cut infield and gets past Smith. Ball only as far as Easton, but free hit conceded. New Zealand ball just outside the 23-metre zone. Ball is thumped in towards the head of the D. It's picked up by Kenny and then spread out wide. First touch, not the greatest from Emily Smith. So Australia ranked just one place higher than New Zealand, but certainly a team on the ascendance. Had a good tournament so far. The Australians only losing out to the Netherlands. Three wins in the other three games against Korea, Japan and Belgium. All 3-2 victories. So not the most convincing of margins, but certainly getting goals on the board. 9 goals scored, 8 goals conceded. New Zealand first time ball from Ferguson, played out wide to Gemma Flynn, one of the danger players up front for the Black Sticks. Good turn of pace from her. And tracked back all the way by Kerry McMahon. Races on here, jab tackle comes in from Whitelock. Now she crunches the ball into the deep. McMahon again it is to tidy things up there in the circle.
Yeah, both these teams are extremely quick and New Zealand love to counter-attack, so they'll want to try and draw Australia out to get some space to allow them to do that. At the same time, though, Australia are very good at zonal marking and defence and very secure, and they're very good at securing traps if the ball's hit in, so it's going to be a great battle and match-up there.
Flanagan there does her role and then takes a break. She's got that right hamstring of hers taped up today. Ball moved round the back. Just into midfield now, and Australia enjoying a nice spell of possession. Lovely turn from Nelson down that right-hand flank. Again, just making sure Australia keep the ball in these early exchanges. Surely not 5 metres there. Gemma Flynn called back by the umpire. If you're just tuning in, you're only a couple of minutes late. Just push back 4 minutes or so ago, and New Zealand 0, Australia 0. Missed touch there from Kirsten Dwyer, takes it out of play. Self-pass, and Nance Korn comes back, working hard to get back behind the ball. That's exactly what Australia need to do in these early exchanges.
Yeah, you're okay, Ella.
Yeah, we'll see their forwards chasing back, and we sometimes call it tackle back or bounce back. So certainly see the forwards coming back to help their midfield out and trying to turn the ball over like they did there.
Always fascinated with the evolution of the terminology, a bounce back. I like that one.
Yeah, a few people call it different things, but everyone's got their name for something.
Good defence at the moment from New Zealand. Again, it's Whitelock at the heart of it, who was denying that channel down the right-hand side for Emily Hertz, who has one goal in the tournament already. Australia with the top goal scorer, Anna Flanagan, on their side as well. She has 5. Not currently on the pitch at the moment. Adam Commons just rotating all his players. And this is Jenna now. 100 caps for her today, spreading that ball out wide. And again, not able to carry the second tackle. A bit too physical there. Again, it was Hertz trying to squeeze through on that right-hand flank and hit the baseline. Smith now picks up the ball and crunches in the D, and no one on the receiving end of it, sadly. There is Flanagan up off the substitutes bench, and alongside her, Parker, White and Claxton McMahon as well, also coming on. So 5 changes for Australia inside the next minute. Here they come, looking for their first real attack of this half. Jenna thumps that one up. That would have been a great take had Emily Smith been able to gather that one.
Yeah, a little bit of a wild one there, but you can see that's the right idea to try and spread the ball out and use the space on the, what we call the help side. So trying to get it from the left-hand side to the right-hand side, where move it away from the New Zealand numbers there.
So New Zealand 4th on 6 points in the pool. Let's see what they can put together. Adam Cummins watches on, clutching match board there, where he writes down all his stats for the first half. Solid defence. Flat stick tackle from Jade Taylor allows this counter-attack. Nance Korn now. Support from Parker and White in the midfield, and in the D if she can get it across. Parker just ahead of her, can't quite find her with that pass. Cover from Liz Thompson. Dennison now. Oh, that's a bad ball, intercepted, and it's White that brings it forward, floats one in behind for Parker. Foot just on the edge of the D. That turnover from Dennison's pass. Ball intercepted. Another chance here for Eastham on the reverse stick. No, peels inside and is blocked by Pump for a long corner.
Yeah, she recognised there was no space on the reverse stick there and just spun back on the forehand.
Ball comes into the D again. It comes up off Dennison's stick. Whitelock comes forward with it. Space on the overlap here on the right-hand side then for Ferguson. Lovely ball ahead, a shooting chance here then for New Zealand to make it 1. And a great save from Rachel Lynch in the Australia goal. She had to come out and narrow the angle as Olivia Merry tried to get into the D and get that shot off. Straight back up the other end now. Nance Korn in the attacking 23, wins the free hit.
We just saw there how dangerous that New Zealand counter-attack can be. If they get a bit of space, they'll run it, and a great save there from the Australian keeper.
Certainly was. Rachel Lynch coming out, narrowing the angle, denying Olivia Merry. Still 0-0. Oh, lovely work from White. Gets past the first tackle, can't get past the second, long corner. Dwyer back through McMahon. Flanagan now. Parker ahead of her, opts to run it herself, muscled off the ball by Merry, but that's a foul. Flanagan keeps going. Again, it's Merry on the reverse stick this time and comes away with it. Ferguson just ahead of her, but nothing higher than that.
Yeah, Australia's done really well to get numbers back around the ball there, just to deny the fast break. And as you see, they're working really hard forwards and trying to get two or three defenders around the Black Sticks attackers there.
Well, it's Ferguson and Punt just trying to link up. Mickelson gets back. Stacey Mickelson there, number 31, certainly one to watch out for, playing in the right half position at the moment as Whitelock pushes the ball forward. Another circle penetration for New Zealand, and the shot comes the wrong side of the goal.
Yeah, we've just seen a couple of times Whitelock pushing through to the midfield and offlaying the ball at the right time to forwards, and it's a great elimination at the top there. And just couldn't quite get the shot across the goal to the far post, but a good effort there. And here's the one-on-one we saw earlier. Great take, and I actually think they played the advantage there because Lynch hit the ball onto the New Zealand girl's foot, but very brave to slide out like that, and you have to get the timing spot on, otherwise you give a corner away or even a stroke.
Yeah, she did that. Super tackle. Mark Hager, the former Australian international, coaching New Zealand these days. Ball forward from Charlton, one touch from Webster, sees it goes off the side of the pitch. Webster with that chance moments ago, got that shot off, wrong side of the goal. Good ball speed on that. McMahon into the midfield. Eastham on the peel. Interception. It's Ferguson again that gathers it, plays it into Whitelock. New Zealand opting to come down that central channel. It was rather packed, but they do win a free hit. Now this can come straight into the circle if they want. Whitelock over the ball. Ferguson out wide. She slaps it in onto the baseline, across the face of Dean. Again, Lynch gets a pad on it. Back out to Ferguson, who clips it in for a second time of asking. And now Australia come away with it. This is Charlton, regathers for New Zealand. Into the foot there of Nelson. Hobbles back and retreats the 5 metres. Merry with the restart onto Flanagan's forehand stick. Punt fancies it. Flanagan had to be fast on her feet there to retreat the 5 metres. Penalty corner, and she was lucky to get away with the first one, to be honest. Flanagan feels she was the 5 metres. She's made the interception.
Okay, just back off. You went down to play the ball.
The five.
Do you want it? You want it? Yes. Okay, no problem.
Yeah, I thought it was a close call in the first one, but she was on the circle edge, which illustrates she had back five, but
Sarah,
that one was slightly harder.
For influencing the play, not backing off 5 meters.
Yeah, I'll take a look.
Okay, thank you.
Did she influence this play, Anna Flanagan? If she did, that's what she's been penalised for. Had she retreated 5 meters? Ferguson, she can't touch it till the dotted line.
She kind of goes back again, realises she's not five, and I think...
Well, it's hard to say, isn't it? Because she hadn't started on the dotted line.
That's interpretation of whether she's influenced the attacker there, but Sana is actually probably lifted into her a little bit and quite high.
Let's have another look at it from this angle. Yeah, she picks it up. Her back foot is on that line, and you've got to say, if she started on the line and went forward into the play, she would have been closer to the player than she was. But yeah, is she influencing
Amy?
The play?
No, she was
got
not 5 metres.
Down.
You can award the penalty corner.
So
Australia,
even though she didn't get the
thank you.
Stick in there, she was influencing the play.
Okay, you have
because
no
she went down with
left,
that flat
right?
Stick.
Yeah, it's got to be, you know, you are influencing the play, even though you're not putting a tackle in, your body and where you're positioning is dictating where the forward goes. And I know they're thinking, well, she's on the dotted line when she's touched the ball. She still influences the play with where her body is and where her positioning is.
Adam Commons, not pleased. Australia concede a penalty corner. It's the first of the game.
Yeah, he's not happy. They've obviously lost their video referral now quite early on in this match, and it could play a part later on in the game.
Good point.
Play!
New Zealand then, first penalty corner from the head of the D. A low flick onto the pads of Lynch, kicked it away as Punt came in with the drag flick. He's just holding a right shoulder in the warm-up. Doesn't seem to be any pain as such there from Anita Punt. Here's the shot on target.
Yeah, nice bit of injection there. Last few games they've struggled with that, mistrapping it. But, yeah, getting the shot on target and trying to get the rebound straight down the middle, but fouled on the... That's great marking, actually, by number 11 McMahon, I think. Just trying to block the attack again on the rebound there and being first to it.
Rachel Lynch as well having to be snappy to get those pads together. Whitelock again with the ball into the D. It's loose, and here's another shot. Reverse stick shot this time, and a far post tipping not far away for Ferguson, who had just appeared on that far post, unable to get anything on it. So again, New Zealand getting close to getting that opening goal here as the ball comes in from Grant this time, and that far post deflection. Well, really, Ferguson should have done better.
Yeah, it was a great snapshot. She didn't have much space to get the backhand away, but did, and it was just a little bobble on it, which made Ferguson's life hard, but certainly in the right position there, and if you keep putting chances in like that, they eventually will fall to you.
New Zealand enjoying a nice passage of play here. Little shove in the back there from Emily Naylor. There'll be a free hit which will be taken by McMahon on the halfway line. Honours relatively even as far as possession goes. New Zealand 54%, Australia 46%. 22 minutes left to play in the first half, still 0-0. New Zealand with the best shooting chances of the game so far. Ball crunched upfield and Glynn was there. Flanagan has to go back, she's got three black sticks around her now. New Zealand really putting on a full press, and Flanagan doing well to play that lifted ball back to McMahon, who now opens up the right-hand side with Parker.
Yeah, Flanagan looking pretty casual there. I would slightly be panicking a bit. Three New Zealand girls chasing down towards you, and you're clearing the ball in the reverse. We see a great drive into the circle here.
Certainly is, and Australia coming up off their foot, sadly, this time. So the Hockey Roos having to concede some ground. Route one ball thumped up the pitch,
hey,
relieves
five,
a bit of the pressure, and...
Five. You watch your drop in your shoulder, OK? Yeah, no worries.
Katie Glynn just getting warned there for dropping the shoulder, presumably in the last tackle that we didn't necessarily see. Deliberate dummy there from Taylor in the midfield of Australia. Dennison for New Zealand, aerial ball from her up to punt.
Keep on, yeah, you're okay.
Bone gathers. Claxton changes that angle, comes in field and throws the ball forward, looking for Nance Corn. Intention was good.
Yeah, Nance Corn was just holding wide there. I think she felt the space was on the outside, whereas the ball was played down the middle inside, and she just couldn't be in both positions there.
The foot. I didn't see the foot. I can't play the ball.
This is Cox. Lovely change of angle from her. Nice from New Zealand. Flynn trying to get something. McMahon denies. Sideline ball.
Yeah, good use of diving on one channel and then using the opposite side of the pitch, shaping up the space, and they certainly had the numbers forward there to commit to that attack.
Yeah, settling down into a nice rhythm this game. 15 minutes played, no goals to report. New Zealand just with the one penalty corner so far now as Nance Corn breaks across the halfway line. This is White ahead of her. Can she get into the circle and get anything off? She's looking for a corner. It gets the shot off as well. Far post wasn't far away. Came up a bit too high for the far post tipping. Emily Hertz there over on the far side as White then manoeuvred.
Yeah, just trying to generate space to get a shot away. She wasn't too sure whether to go forehand or backhand. Went for the backhand option in the end, but the angle was quite tight there. And as you see, just a little bit high as well for the back post player.
Whitelock for New Zealand. This is Punt. Lovely skills. Clips it into the D. Flanagan again gathers. Good, solid, upright stick. Again, New Zealand come forward. Lovely passage of play. This is Cox into the D. Again, Australia clearing their lines. It's Bone that comes away with it. Only as far as Punt, though, and New Zealand relentless here. Mickelson this time tries to get through again. Bone gets something on it. Be a long corner now.
Yeah, Australia's so good at making those traps in the circle. I think they're used to obviously being zonal marking and facing each other, hitting the ball into them in training, and they don't miss many traps like that.
Oh, lovely skills from Stacey Mickelson on the edge of the D to get in, but good composure from Kenny there to make the final challenge. Like scrappy stuff down in this bottom corner, but Cox now has a go. Anita Punt will have a crack. Ball eventually comes into the circle again. But coming up off Cox's stick this time, McMahon winning the free hit back for Australia and some sense of relief. Interesting phase of play down in that bottom corner. Now Flanagan gives chase to this ball. Didn't have much power or pace on it and intercepted by Thompson. Takes it out for a sideline ball. Thompson again, this time it'll be a long corner. Dennison standing strong on the baseline now. New Zealand with four shirts on the edge of that D. Denying that route one pass to the goal.
You see that right hand area on the baseline becoming important for both teams here, and it's how well you can defend that.
Thumped in towards goal. Oh, reverse stick shot was wild. Advantage played and Punt comes away with it. Good jab tackle from Jenna, wins the free hit back. Route one ball from Jenna's a goodie. Now onto the reverse stick with White. Free hit, no, penalty corner inside the team. Yes, please. Yeah. Well done.
White did really well there. We saw a chance earlier where she wasn't sure how to generate space and went for a shot in the backhand. This time she went to the backhand space and then didn't take the shot this time or the cross, but just pulled it back onto her New Zealand foot. And it's whether you defend that space along the baseline or whether you defend your feet, and you've got to try and do both in that area.
One more New Zealand.
Yeah, sometimes tough to juggle the two. So Flanagan at the head of the D, top goal scorer in the tournament so far with five goals. Eastham casually makes her way to the injection spot. Also Kenny at the head of the D as well. Remember, she's got two in the tournament so far. So Flanagan or Kenny, the options for Australia. Comes Kenny's way, the trap actually came off a foot for Australia. Not the best penalty corner. Gives New Zealand the chance to counter-attack. Dennison up high. Nice 1-2 to Mickelson, who'll get the shot off the back foot. Two players ahead of her. Ball then comes across the face of D, but way too high. Blazes it across the crossbar from Cox on this near side.
Yeah, the corner, they just moved, the injection was off, so the trapper had to move and couldn't quite get across there. She probably should have perhaps gone forehand trap there and shoot herself. And then we saw a really fast counter-attack from the corner, and New Zealand had probably five players up in that circle and just didn't make the most of it there.
Yeah, Flynn and Cox had actually taken positions outside of the post for Mickelson's shot on the counter-attack. Getting ever closer to that elusive first goal as Whitelock brings it down. She's got two Aussie girls around her. Mickelson is here now. First touch from her wasn't the greatest.
Sorry, no boy.
Offlays the ball now to Charlton. Hopeful ball infield there. There were three Australian shirts between her and the line to goal. Again, the first touch, just letting both sides down at the moment here.
Yeah, it was a scrappy pass, really. She just kind of flicked it at her and it had a bit of a bounce and a skip, and it makes her life so much harder. Again, there, another bouncing ball that's mistrapped, and that was an easy pass, you know, a 10-yard pass where you literally have to make it flat and stick to stick, and it's a case of whether tiredness is coming into play or just being sloppy there, really.
Yeah, it is just a bit scrappy all over the pitch, really, as Eastham shows full commitment there to launch herself at the ball. Comes off and Taylor replaces her. But look at that, at full stretch, she definitely had the intent to get there first. Now Australia with Bone with that diagonal ball into the D. It's gone up into the New Zealand defender and it's going to be a penalty corner for Australia. Let's see if they can convert it this time. Made a bit of a hash of it last time round, but they'll have their second penalty corner of the game as Madonna Blythe watches on. Here's why.
Yeah, again, bouncing pass, but we've seen Australia make so many traps like that and be really secure, but New Zealand just looking a bit on edge and haven't made so many secure traps in that area. And it, you know, just putting the ball into that danger zone can create corners like that.
Liz Thompson conceding the penalty corner for New Zealand, and now four defenders and the goalkeeper look to keep New Zealand in this game. Australia look to get their noses in front. Jodie Kenny, alongside her, Edwina Bone. Comes out to Kenny this time. Low flick and a little deflection in front of the goalkeeper. They haven't got a video referral, remember, Australia. Umpires saying they saw stick. They don't have a video referral. Otherwise, I think they would ask.
Australia still in open play, looking to get the opening goal. That's a lovely bit of skill. The shot comes away eventually, and then the hockey slap, goal bound as well, denied by Rutherford. It was Emily Smith over on that far post that had a couple of chances.
That was a great crossfield pass from the long corner there to top of the D. Just New Zealand didn't quite get a defence set up right there. And we see this corner again. The trapper moves really late to set that up. Kenny moved wide and just to get that angle. And I think he came off the flyer's stick there and deflected into the Australian gear. I think they might have been calling for high ball. But as you say, they haven't got a video referral to ask for that.
Yeah, just on first glance there, I have to agree with you. Deflection came off the number one runner. Went into the Australian player at a dangerous height. First time touch is helped on, and now some space for Nance Corn on the left-hand flank. Cuts in field. It was a good lead run from Emily Hertz to take the defender away from her. So important what's happening off the ball, those runs that open up a bit of space, as Madonna Blythe, the captain, now passes this ball in, and the shot comes from Hertz. Again, Hertz drives. Still going here, Australia. Finally, New Zealand gather it, but not for long. Gemma Flynn unable to get a touch on it, and it'll be a sideline ball with McMahon. Out through the midfield now. Thrust forward by Jenna. Finds Bone. Long corner. Well, New Zealand back. All 11 players inside the 23-metre zone. They come away with it. That means they haven't got too many high players forward. Gemma Flynn fancies it, though. Just lost control with that final touch, and Australia regather possession. Ball forward this time from Taylor. Mrs. Blythe does find Hertz. Good tackle. Thompson again on that near touchline.
Yeah, just needs to get that cross, that, you know, away from the keeper. It's in the goalkeeper's space, so it needs to get more of an angle if she's looking for the back post or whether it's a shot at goal. It's going to be tough to beat her from there.
Yeah, Sally Rutherford had that near post covered. Not much power in it as well from Emily Hertz. So 11 minutes to play. Australia have lost their video referral early on here in the game. Anna Flanagan was penalised for not retreating 5 metres. They went to video referral, lost the video referral. Would have come in very handy a moment ago. Circle penetrations, just 4 for New Zealand, 8 for Australia. But those 4 attacks for New Zealand have been causing a fair bit of trouble. Australia, on the other hand, have had just one more penalty corner as well. 2-1. In their favour.
We've just seen a bit of a momentum shift, actually, and Australia seems to have just got into this game a little bit more, and although New Zealand have probably had the better chances and more clear-cut ones, we see Australia with a lot more possession now and trying to build it a little bit, but it's just not falling for them in the circle quite.
Is that important, momentum? You talk about it there. Do you recognise that as players and say in your heads, this is the time to go?
Yeah, you just notice it in your head a little bit, that you feel like you're in the game, or you feel... You know, it's really negative if you feel like you're chasing it the whole time. So we just see Anita Punt running here. Offlays it nicely.
Yeah, crossfield ball comes along. Yeah, it was...
No pushing, no pushing!
Madonna Blythe to Flanagan. Little lift on that one. Nelson under the arm. Only as far as Naylor.
Yeah, as a player, it certainly can get in your head. It's very negative if you keep chasing it. As you just see the chance again with the little reverse stick bunt across. But, yeah, just a great touch in front there by Flanagan, I believe.
Here is Flanagan on the ball now. That's, well, free hit foot there, spotted by the umpire. A couple of the New Zealand girls taking some shade. Blazing sunshine out there in the centre of the pitch. Blythe again in the midfield for Australia. Out with that injury, remember, at the beginning of the tournament, but playing a full part in the last few games now. Back up and running. Doesn't seem to be suffering. Had a chat with her this morning and was in good spirits ahead of the game. Saw the Aussie girls wandering in. Oh, brilliant. Excellent from Ferguson to gather that. Right underneath it, the Australian defender was not 5 metres. That's why New Zealand maintained possession here and have won the free hit. Whitelock forward. One touch on from punt, and the shot comes across the face of goal. Cox gets the final touch. It'll be a 16-yard hit for Australia. Well, final touch actually came off an Australian player, so the defence doing well there to get something on it to deny Cox that shot. Can't do anything from the resulting long corner, and now Parker breaks for Australia. Got a bit of space ahead of her. Nance Corn is the only supporting player in the circle. May have to come back out and round with Kelly White in support. Parker decides to go forward herself. Into the D now. Can't carry the last tackle.
Yeah, Parker did really well there. She's very much on her own. She did well to kind of hold up the play and keep possession, as we just see her.
Blythe with the ball into the D. Nance Corn the target. And tapped away this time by Charlton. It'll be a long corner for Australia. Just needs a goal this game, just to bring it to life. Australia will take the 1 point from the game. That's no problem at all. That would see them go on to 10 points. Foot there from Bone. Anita Punt shows her pace down that right-hand flank, gets her feet around it, keeps it in play, gets into the D. Punt first time slap, and the shot goes wide from Ferguson. That the best chance of the half for New Zealand to get ahead.
Great speed there by Anita Punt. It looked like she wasn't going to keep that in. She did, and then she accelerated past Flanagan, and the run cut her out, and it's a great ball back. She had a look, and you expect Krista Ferguson to put that away every time, pretty much, but wrong-footed keeper just crept outside the post there.
Yeah, sadly, wrong side of the post for Mark Hager and the Black Sticks. Still 0-0. 6.5 left to play. Free hit goes the other way. New Zealand ball. Good reactions from Punt, who wasn't quite ready for that ball, but she got played by Mickelson. Ball's loose again, and Webster's the first to gather it. Whitelock ahead of her. Good flat stick tackle from McMahon, but there was a foul in there as well. Whitelock will take the free hit on the dotted line, just outside the edge of the circle. So both teams have to be 5 metres.
Yeah, Punt looking lively this game, but I've just seen a wave to want to come off, so whether she's still struggling, I don't know. She's got her knee heavily strapped, and she's holding her shoulder in the warm-up, so she's struggling at it, but she's been certainly involved in a lot of the key attacks for New Zealand.
Yeah, she's probably slightly blind from that last run that she made from just outside the 23, it was, into the circle, set up that shooting opportunity for Ferguson, and now just puts in a final dash here again. Maybe she's got a little bit of juice left in the tank. No, says McMahon, picks it up. Great tackle from there, and here's a bit of space. Three forward now for Australia, as Emily Smith is unable to get her feet around it. There's another chance, though, with Taylor. Taylor winning the free hit. There is Punt just taking a well-earned rest. Good running. Grant and Thompson also waiting to come on for New Zealand. In the meantime, Australia coming around the back. Very casual from Kenny to make that pass. Oh dear, that's loose. Whitelock intercepts. Gonna have to go herself here. Glynn infield, Whitelock just playing it onto a foot of Bone.
Yeah, she's a little bit alone there, didn't have any support. The support was all on the other side of the pitch, and she couldn't quite get it across. So she, Whitelock had to run there herself, but did well to keep the free hit.
Cox moves it the 5 metres. Good strength from Bone in the tackle.
Nothing.
Well, it's been a very scrappy first half, this. As you'd expect, really, between these two sides. Mickelson comes forward again. Can she get into the circle? Another circle penetration. Little lift over there, over the final defender's stick. Oh, and Australia had to be so careful there. Almost in hockey roo fashion there, just hopping over the ball. All three defenders had to be alert to the danger. Remember, a foot inside the circle would be a penalty corner. And Anita Punt there, just using her inhaler just to catch her breath. just a moment alone of isolation inside the dugout, just to gather a breath. So that's punt pitch side, so might have been Sophie Cox. Kept in play. Glynn then. Inside the final 3 minutes of the first half. No goals to bring you. Australia win the free hit. Nance Corn cuts in field. Hurry.
That was good.
Australia electing to run with the ball there, and now New Zealand have it back with Flynn. There's Punt, who's back on the field, chased down by Madonna Blythe. Good cover tackle from her. Stick challenge too on Blythe. Australia with acres of room over on the right-hand side, opting to come down that left-hand flank. Anna Flanagan was 100% open there on the right-hand side.
Yeah, they should have transferred that out of the numbers there. The ball had just come down that left-hand side and they needed to out put that out to the right, so there was a lot of space going on, and I'm sure that'll be a point they'll try and raise at half-time.
Yeah, it just comes down to communication, and Australia didn't have it on that attack. Bone casually watches that one go over the baseline, so a restart for Australia on the 15-metre line. Slightly sleepy finish to the end of this first half. First time touchdown the line from Anna Flanagan. That was the right idea. Interception now for Australia, and they've got numbers over here. Nance Corn picks it up on the edge of the circle. Strong challenge from Samantha Charlton, who was the first to react, got to it, recognised the danger, got that flat stick tackle in, long corner. White with a dangerous ball into the circle. Takes us into the final minute. Don't think Hertz, unless she was about 12 foot, was ever going to reach that one.
Yeah, I'm not sure it was that dangerous. I mean, it cleared everyone quite easily there.
Easton with the challenge in the midfield that gets possession back for Blythe. Strong blow of the whistle. Another hard tackle from Thompson gives away the free hit. Flanagan thinks about clipping it into the circle. Clean tackle, says the umpire, as Naylor brings it away. Punt over on that far side. Was thinking about the aerial, couldn't get underneath it. Final few seconds of the first half. Important challenge again from Charlton. Had Nance Corn behind her. And it's going to be a goalless first half. Say New Zealand had the better of the chances. But both teams go in at the break, goalless. It's New Zealand 0, Australia 0. So certainly Crystal Ferguson, for me, had the best of the chances in that first half for New Zealand. Australia, two penalty corners inside the first half. And a few saves for Sally Rutherford in the New Zealand goal. No goals to report, though, as both sides head off the pitch for a well-deserved break. Sun beating down here, just coming up to 11:15 local time, but baking hot as the sides gather themselves. The coaches will have their input here. Mark Hager and Adam Commons step up to chat to both their sides. And we'll be back with all the second half action at halftime. It's New Zealand 0, Australia 0.
Back and forth. So I don't know where to go.
Welcome back. New Zealand 0, Australia 0. Half-time here at the Rabobank Hockey World Cup 2014. This final pool game for both sides. Water going on the pitch. Nice, slick surface to play on in the second half in the Dutch sunshine. Quite a strange first half, but I'd say New Zealand with the better of the chances. Olivia Mary coming close there, denied by Rachel Lynch, who had to get up off her goal line to deny Mary. Great ball into space and just looked to bring it inside, but Lynch going to ground, losing a helmet in the process as well. New Zealand this time, punt and Whitelock linking up to get that shot. And then the deflection on the far post could have come in from Ferguson. She had several of those chances in the first half, couldn't get anything on it. This one of the better chances for Australia inside the first half. A reverse stick shot on the backhand there from Kelly White, taking the tomahawk shot, but just couldn't get it on target. New Zealand showing great pace down that right-hand flank with Anita Punt. Ferguson, the first time slap hit, going the wrong side of the goal. That the best chance of the half. Anita Punt showing her skills and what she does best, getting around the back there. So Ferguson with a couple of chances for the New Zealand girls. 0-0 it remains. Six shots apiece. Fairly even as well as when it comes to circle penetrations. 8-9. Australia just ahead by one there. None from two from the penalty corners for Australia. None from one for New Zealand. With New Zealand just about controlling possession in their opponent's half. Plenty of ways to get involved. On Twitter, at FIH underscore hockey, hashtag RHWC 2014. Also on Facebook, facebook.com/FIHockey. The Australian contingent here that have travelled to The Hague. Flanagan and Nelson just coming back out into the arena, the Kaisea Stadium. And there's a look at the table as things stand. 3 points for New Zealand here would take them up onto 9 points. Then it would come down to goal difference. Korea also with a chance, well, a slim chance. They have the Netherlands later this evening. But a win essential for Australia if they're to make the semi-finals. They need all 3 points here to guarantee it. Both sides out onto the pitch. New Zealand already there. Will gather. Australia on their way. And talking of Australia, let's get the thoughts of Adam Commons at half-time. He's with Quinton Hull.
Well, Adam, it seemed that the intensity of your previous game may have had a telling factor on the way you started here. Did you assess it that way?
Look, I think New Zealand have played a smart game. We had a number of objectives that we wanted to put into place. And probably we don't have the same energy as we did the other night. It's quite warm this morning. That's going to play a factor. But I think if we just lift that energy a little, we hold possession a bit more and we run New Zealand around, then we'll give ourselves every chance. I think if we look at the stats, it's pretty even. We've had opportunities, so have they. They're the number five team in the world, we're number four. You'd expect nothing more than an Australia-New Zealand battle.
I know you weren't happy with the core, but concerning that you've lost your referral?
Yeah, very disappointing. There's markings on the field for a reason. We touched the ball on the 5 metre line. That means the ball's gone 7 metres. So for me, that's clear. But unfortunately, we just have to move on now. We're going to do well. We need to put these goals away.
Good luck in the second half.
Thanks a lot.
Yeah, some goals would be nice. 0-0 at half time. Australia not playing to their full potential. They have enjoyed goals aplenty in their games against Korea, Japan and Belgium. Three in each of those games. They did lose to the host, the Netherlands, the other night, though. As for New Zealand, well, a 4-3 win against Belgium. 1-0 loss to Korea. A 2-0 loss again to the hosts. And a 4-1 win against Japan. Hopefully goals and goals galore in the second half. Fingers crossed. Second half about to get underway then. New Zealand 0, Australia 0. Australia with the pushback. Here we go, game on. Australia attacking left to right as the Black Sticks defending that goal away to our right-hand side. Pick it up with Whitelock in the midfield. Oh, yes. Here's a chance early on. Glynn opted to go herself. Unable to get past Kenny. Was it the right decision? She had support ahead of her on the baseline. Let's have another look at it.
Yeah, great pick up on the reverse and just tries to eliminate, but couldn't quite get through and then fouls. But as you say, she had the support running towards the baseline, but it's just closing the angle down. But she decided to take the dribble option herself there.
Adam Commons mentioned it in his halftime interview, but Australia have lost their video referral. New Zealand still have theirs if they need to use it at any stage in this second half. It's Australia, though, on the attack here with Smith. Easton now, again at full stretch to make sure Australia maintain possession there. And then the foot, well earned in the end by Kelly White. And we're going to see the video referral used.
Chico, did you see a foot?
Yeah.
You did Australia?
Australia
foot, okay.
Well, no video referral required. The two umpires instead communicating across the radio wavelength.
Yeah, clear foot there, as you see, but yeah, went for the TV referral, but the two umpires helping helping each other out there to clear that one up.
Yeah, who needs it? It's good. Good that they're in touch throughout the game, throughout the tournament. Linked up and able to communicate before, during, and after the game. So, 0-0. Where are your bets here, Chloe? Who's going to get the score for us? Who's going to get this going? Who's going to get the first goal? We're desperate for it as Bone brings it down. Bone again in attack. And again, you've got to say, not five. Exactly the same incident as in the first half. Lucky not to concede a penalty corner.
Yeah, I can see why the Australians are so angry there. And the captain, Captain Madonna's just having a word.
That's fine, yeah. But what is the difference when you're deliberately not five?
We've got penalty. We're just moving on, okay, from here.
I'd like to explain it. I don't see the difference.
Yeah, she just wants to see how it's gone there, 5 yards, and gone in there, 5 yards.
I do understand your frustration.
No, I'm not
going to.
Okay.
But
so here
we go.
Okay.
Don't have an answer.
We'll talk about it afterwards, okay?
Valid point. 100% valid on that occasion.
Yeah, I didn't think Madonna's life was going to back down there, but she's going to have to, otherwise she'll be carded.
Well, she has to. The umpire's not going to change her mind.
Yeah.
And that's a face injury, okay. So loud blow on the whistle, taking time off there and just making sure White back up on her feet. Yeah, could have been nasty. McMahon. Easton. Well, I just heard from Adam Commons there, just when they were sort of around the circle area. Get it, Adam. Get it, Adam. He wants that ball into the D. He wants to put pressure on New Zealand.
Yeah, I guess they want to play them at their own game a little bit. And those quick restarts, to say when they can get a chance to move it to space or take the free hit when they're not quite set and quite ready, it generates the opportunity for Australia to get a shot at goal. But just slowing the play down a little bit there, Australia not being able to take the free hit quickly due to an injury.
Goal.
And
goal.
New Zealand marking really tightly in the circle.
Well, it's a green card. Just trying to identify who it's for. Was it for Whitelock?
Yeah, I believe it's Whitelock. It's just taking a seat down there, but just for 2 minutes, so not too long.
I didn't quite see what for, unfortunately, really, because she carried about six tackles, and then I think in her final one, when she'd lost possession, making the green card offence, or drawing the green card offence.
I'm sorry.
Free hit just outside, won by Bly. Chance here for Australia then to open the scoring. Ball comes into the D, little deflection over the goalkeeper. Final touch came in from Emily Hertz, and there's going to be another video referral here. Will this goal stand, or will Australia take the lead? Stay tuned to find out.
I thought she made an attempt to stop the ball, so do you want to refer that?
They're not entirely sure what they're going to refer here, but they feel like they should do something just to try and challenge this goal.
For me, yes. It's up
I think they're saying that the ball wasn't stopped when she took the free hit, and it was all continuous play, but they're unsure still.
Yes.
Just check it.
Do you want Yes, okay.
Well, no harm in checking. New Zealand go for the
Carol,
video referral.
Yeah, you can see it's an attempt to stop the ball.
Yep.
Was there an attempt to stop the ball? Let's have your opinion, Chloe. What do you think?
No, the ball was rolling, I have to say, but it's not moving very fast, the ball.
We probably need to see the build-up into that as well. There's no doubt about the goal. Goal was a good one by Emily Hertz with that final little chip over Bianca Russell.
Yeah, it's where Flanagan starts with the ball. She kind of does take it all in one go, but I've certainly seen that happen quite a lot all over the tournament, really.
Interesting seeing it in reverse. So there's the ball, it's moving.
Yeah, it's just rolling back to her and she hasn't stopped it, but they've not actually pulled it up in many of the other games, so it's questionable.
Straight away, though, you can see the New Zealand players protesting. It's not stopped dead on the dotted line or where the free hit was to be taken from. That's the point here.
It's actually a very good call by the New Zealand girls to notice that and to refer it. As I say, part of the rules, it has to be stopped dead and it wasn't. And that's going back to the Adam Collins shouting at him to get at him and take the quick free hits. Well, there's taking it quick and there's actually making sure it's stopped. It's two very different things there. And she took it so quick, the New Zealand girls had their backs to play even, and that's a bit of an unfair advantage.
Well, the video umpire, Carol Metchett, will have a look at it from several different angles. We're just showing you what we've got here from our TV broadcast side of things. And then Amy Baxter down there, the USA umpire.
Okay, Amy.
We'll get some instruction
now.
There
was no attempt to stop the ball, okay. So you can award a free out.
Yep.
And New Zealand keep their referral.
Excellent, thank you.
So no goal is the decision. No attempt to stop the ball by Anna Flanagan.
Time's out, okay? You have your referral.
New Zealand
you still have
keep referral, their referral.
So there'll be a 16 coming out, okay? Okay. 16.
Yeah, it's a really 16, great, 16. A great call from New Zealand there to be switched on and aware of that. And as you say, they noticed it straight away because they weren't ready
16,
and set for the free hit.
Okay.
We're back underway. Australia's goal by Emily Hertz denied.
Okay.
Certainly a better passage of play for them in the build-up to the goal. And now Australia regained possession. And very much at half-time, they would have been told to come out and give 100% in this second half. A win for New Zealand makes things interesting. We'll take them to 9 points alongside Australia, and still with the chance, if Korea were to beat the Netherlands, of Korea qualifying and going through in Pool A.
Play on.
If not, it would come down to goal difference.
Nothing, too hard.
Flanagan with the ball in. Smith on the turn, wins the free hit. Will they stop it dead this time? Yeah, Madonna Blythe makes sure of that. Jenna just over on this right-hand side to Kenny. Here's a chance. It's good defensive work from Sophie Cox up there. She's centre forward, but back now doing some defensive work for New Zealand. Ferguson too is back there. Nance Korn. Crossfield to Flanagan. And Whitelock is back on the pitch from her green card. So New Zealand back up to full strength. Well, so far, the New Zealanders set their defence is standing firm, rigid. Haven't conceded today. Well, they have, but it was disallowed. Australia again round the back. Baseline option was open to drive for Emily Hertz. A bit surprised she didn't take it on there.
Yeah, she had in her mind she was looking for the corner, and actually the dribble option to cut along the baseline was clearly on, and she was too worried about trying to get that ball on her foot.
Slap forward. Slightly more open game in this second half. Australia with possession. This is a nice passage of play with Flanagan now on the right-hand side. Not able to be kept in, though, by Kelly White. It's been a strange game, this one, hasn't it?
Yeah, it's not quite happening for either team, but Australia's certainly looking to try and push on here and use the whip and try and stretch New Zealand out and create pockets of space. But it's certainly not quite happening for either team. New Zealand are really struggling at the moment to clear the ball out their own defence.
Too far, play it.
They enjoyed a fair amount of the possession in the first half. Two good shooting opportunities too for Crystal Ferguson for New Zealand. Could have also scored through Olivia Merry, but no goals as yet. Australia, two penalty corners from the game as Whitelock comes forward for New Zealand. On the back foot here, a chance again for Merry then on the baseline, pulls it back, and punt was the target. Ferguson now picks it up. Jab tackle. Australia concede another free hit on the edge of their circle this time. Whitelock can thump this one. Goal bound again, was looking for the deflection from Merry. Couldn't get a stick on it.
Yeah, nice build up from free here. Charlin gets the ball away really quick and a great angle. And Flanagan just using her body to get in the way there, defend that. And it's done a great job of it.
Well, Merry will be disappointed she didn't get a stick on it. Flanagan this time goes to turf. Can't keep that ball in play. New Zealand will have it. Webster thinks about taking it, leaves it in the end for Thompson. Dennison now. Naylor to her right. No attackers on that wide flank position. Not a great deal of movement off the ball from either side here.
No, as I say, both teams struggling. Just need to sort of structure and shape out and try and build possession and build into the game a little bit. Australia seems to be doing this a bit better, but then they're going forcible like that, but have fortunately hit a foot. But they're just trying to rush it a little bit. And I think it is about building it up and trying to get, you know, into this game more. And New Zealand needs to get more possession, certainly.
And Sophie Cox comes off for another break. Sorry, using a inhaler at the end of that first half. Seems okay in the second. Nance Corn with a quick restart, and there was not five again from New Zealand.
16 goal.
Well, it's a green card for Thompson. I think Australia would have preferred a penalty corner again here. It happened inside the 23 metre zone.
Yeah, Corns is going ballistic down below as he's shouting, saying corner, and I can see why they had a card in the corner against them first half, and you don't mind if it does go against you, but you expect the same when it comes back the other way.
Well, it's twice now that's happened in the second half. This time, though, a green card being shown to New Zealand's number 16, Liz Thompson. That means Australia can take advantage of the extra player on the pitch. There's Thompson in the sin bin for 2 minutes. Australia will press high here. Whitelock over the ball. Naylor. Important passage of play this for New Zealand defensively. They just need to hold on to the ball just whilst they're down to 10 players at least. Keep that away from Australia. For Australia, good chance to attack, and now they have possession in the midfield. McMahon will take the restart. Flanagan. Route one ball picked up from Parker. Nelson now. She clips it in into the D. It's loose there. Mickelson gathers, but only as far as Nelson again. Parker first to it, stick challenge. Eastham not able to get to that ball. For me at the moment, Australia just looking about a second or so off the pace.
For tackling?
Flanagan, wild swing that time. Wasn't dangerous, says the umpire. Kenny with the ball in. Important defensive touch this time from Dennison for the long corner. Reverse stick, tip on it. Oh, lovely skill from White on the baseline. Couldn't quite get past the second tackle of Dennison.
But it's okay.
Flanagan comes out this time through Kenny.
Yeah, Australia really attacking this right-hand side. It's really congested, and they're just trying to transfer here to the space, but not done it quick enough, and New Zealand have been able to cover it. So they're looking to go back to this right-hand side and Great trap there for Flanagan.
And New Zealand back up to 11 players.
Play, nothing.
So that advantage that Australia had for those 2 minutes is over. Such a scrappy game between these two sides. It's one of those that they'll label ugly. But if either side can come out with a result, well, that certainly keeps things exciting. For New Zealand, it's a must-win game. They have to win to stand any chance of going through to the semi-finals.
Yeah, they're just a bit scrappy on their passing at the moment. They're just winning the ball and then giving it away really cheaply, New Zealand. There we see it again. Just not quite connecting, and we need to go back to the basics of passing stick to stick here, because they're really struggling to the pressure's just building on them.
It certainly is. Into the circle this time, though. Ball comes across, does it? No. Charlton cuts that one out. Eastham now. It's a bit hit and hope from these areas from Australia. And whilst Adam Commons has said, get the ball into the circle as often and as quick as you can, you've got to at least find your teammates. Yeah, energy, there's a word. Doesn't feel like there's much energy behind this performance. Both sides looking a little lackluster out there.
Case.
Punt with the ball forward. Now some space for Mary. Two on one. Didn't really stand much of a chance against McMahon. Goes second best, and well, McMahon was trying to back off there. No intention of moving out of the way of Olivia Mary.
It's really difficult in those situations when the attacker just drives. Just drive straight at you. It's really hard to know what to do, because you are backing off, but at the same time.
That's come up off a Australia stick into Kenny's knee. And that's going to hurt. Let's see if she can get back to her feet. Hopefully she can. Here's why she went down.
Yeah, hit pretty hard and straight at her, and can't really get out of the way of that. It's going to be a painful one, but I'm sure she'll just kind of jog it off and hopefully carry on.
Yeah, she'll grin and bear it.
These Aussies are pretty tough.
Crowd love it. Certainly appreciate it when a player takes it like that and then just gets straight back up to get on with the game. New Zealand trying to get on with things a bit too early there. Stacey Mickelson with the restart. She's got punt in support. Comes out through Naylor off the back foot. And Australia getting numbers behind it. Also getting numbers four. That's a lovely floated ball in behind. It finds Hertz. Hertz cuts infield, but only as far as Dennison.
Yeah, it was a great ball down the line. She just floated at the right weight so she can run onto it, and a lot of people would have just blasted it off the end of the pitch, so it was nicely played.
Sadly, to no avail for the Black Sticks. So New Zealand, ranked fifth in the world, up here against their rivals, the nemesis that is Australia. One place higher than them in the world rankings. Australia, remember, two times winners of the Hockey World Cup in 1994 and 1998, as Whitelock comes forward now for New Zealand.
Yes. Go.
Well, was Madonna Blythe five there? I don't think she was. Now that turnover of possession plays into Australia's hands. The reverse stick shot. Not enough power behind it from Emily Smith. Long corner, which Smith will take. Australia sensing this is the time to attack. Dennison had to gather that ball. It wasn't the easiest of picks. She had Emily Hertz behind her, then throws her, takes the aerial ball down to Ferguson, who had the best of the chances in the first half. Stretches her legs now in the second, and again, another good cover tackle. Flanagan now picks up on the left-hand flank. Can't beat punt. Does win the free hit, though.
Yeah, great aerial ball out the defence there, and it's just cleared all the danger nice and calmly, and actually set up a great attacking chance there for Crystal Ferguson.
Well, it's just something in the air this evening or this afternoon, because Parker there struggling for breath as she comes off. It's muggy, it's hot, not the nicest environment to play in. And these players are certainly suffering out there. Sluggish manner in which this game has been battled out. And there's still 19 and a half minutes to go. New Zealand 0, Australia 0.
Yeah, I think it was pure sunshine yesterday, and today it's more humidity. And certainly on their fifth game, it's going to be tiring.
Yeah, teams giving it their all. Desperate to get their name on the World Cup. Netherlands looking rather comfortable in their quest to win it this year. Who will challenge them for it? Could be one of these two teams that qualifies with the Netherlands. New Zealand have to win. Australia can guarantee a semi-final berth with a win here. Still that game between the Netherlands and Korea to play out later this afternoon. That the 4 p.m. pushback. Free hit goes the other way. New Zealand ball. Looks like McMahon's just taken one on the finger there, all taped up and ready to get back into the game, get back into the mix. Flanagan striding forward. There's a look at possession inside the 23-metre zone. So the attacking 23-metre zone, Australia spending 61% of their time in it. Great stick skills from Sophie Cox. Tracked back every step of the way, though, by McMahon, using every ounce of her experience to ensure Australia get the ball back there. Kenny as well, just making sure there was no way through. First stick pick was good from White. Cross in is good as well, but as is that, that reverse stick pick from the defender. Emily Naylor had to be at her best there. How important are those takes as Anita Punt watches on at those areas, those key areas, both sides at the moment able to pick up the ball. Again, Naylor doing it there in an important position on the field.
Oh, it's massively key because, one, it just limits the opportunities to either team, but also just generates attack. But at the moment, they're winning a lot of ball. Both, this is the same for both teams, but just their final pass has given it away and not quite connecting. But you see Australia try again, intercepted again, not quite making the final pass. And it's becoming really scrappy because either team is giving the ball away and don't generate any chances.
Emily Naylor, that's three in a row for her. This next one sets up Sophie Cox's attack. There's three on three here. Ferguson can't gather it on the reverse. Webster there, though, continuing this attack. It'll be a long corner. Initially, a great break down that right-hand flank from Cox. Webster now with the long corner restart. Parker back on the pitch. We saw her struggling for breath as well. All these players giving it their all in this crunch match between New Zealand and Australia. New Zealand hasn't had too much success against Australia since the Olympics in 2012. Australia qualifying as continental champions of Oceania.
Tackle's good.
And winning in their last encounter in the Six Nations.
Okay.
0-0 as things stand at the moment, though. Ball into the circle again.
Tackle's good, play!
Clean tackles coming in for New Zealand. That, the opposite of clean. Dirty.
Yeah, it's getting a bit frustrated there. I think that the ball's not falling for them, and New Zealand making a lot of challenges, but yeah, just trying to break down the play earlier there so they can't break.
Ashley Nelson, the villain on this occasion. Whitelock with the restart from the halfway line. Acres of room out wide, but electing to come through this central channel. Ferguson now hits it in. McMahon gets something on it. Blasted away by Nelson, all the way up the other end. Kenny off for a breather. New Zealand back all the way into their own half now, and Australia pressing at about a 75% press. Naylor with the restart. Thompson one way, elects to go Charlton on the right-hand flank. This is Mickelson. Back to Charlton, nice 1-2 down the right-hand flank. Webster thinks about cutting in field, but is stopped in the tracks. They'll have the restart on the halfway line.
Yeah, much better there by New Zealand. Just trying to build the play and say try and get more possession, because at the moment they've been very much outplayed this half, and be looking to try and get some chances here if they can, and just get into this second half before it's too late for them.
Whitelock comes to this near side with Thompson now. Liz Thompson with the hit in, takes a deflection for a long corner. Punt with the restart, not shy of confidence, came back onto Mary's foot. It'll be Australia's ball. McMahon getting in the defensive tackle. It's Easton who's down on the ground. Just getting some medical attention on that right leg. Looks to be that white right hamstring, if anything, as Whitelock comes forward. Oh, great strength in the tackle. Mickelson. Looking to go around the outside of Hertz. Well, both teams resilient in defence, and they're bringing players back, which just means they're not able to counter-attack.
Yeah, it's just denying any space or any opportunities to go forward really quickly, and as you see, the New Zealand forwards running back there to break down the play, so it's just keeping that work rate up to limit these chances. And we see again the New Zealand forwards trying to really limit high up there. Merry sliding to get that one, and just disturbs Australia's play here, and they can't get any meaningful ball forward.
Kenny and Flanagan back to come on. Kenny makes her substitution and will take the restart. Flanagan waits in the wings. Just two penalty corners for Australia in the game. One for New Zealand as Smith gathers the ball now. A bit more space, but opted to go across the open stick there of Whitelock, and that wasn't the best decision. Now New Zealand come forward. Charlton down the right-hand flank. Tracked back every inch of the way by Ashley Nelson, who's working hard out there. Mickelson to Whitelock with Dennison outside. This is Dennison in field. Ferguson plays it out. Good pace on it. Deflection ball into the D from Mickelson. And another long corner for New Zealand.
Yeah, that's certainly a way of trying to generate space when you there's not much room about. It's the first time deflections around the circle edge, and that's been quite successful for both teams. I'd like to see them try that a little bit more, actually.
It is packed over there in the top right-hand corner for the New Zealand attack. They opt to come out and around, changing the angle, looking to move the New Zealand line of defence. That route one line to goal is blocked, but it does find a way, a bobbly way through. It's Kenny with a cool head. And eventually Australia coming away with it. Kenny again over the ball. Australia looking to get to the semi-final stages. A win here will secure that. New Zealand need that win to go level on points with Australia. And then they both watch on that Korea-Netherlands game later this afternoon. Korea win that, they go through. Oh, lovely space here for Webster to take advantage of. The ball comes goal bound. Last touch was an Australian touch. It'll be a long corner. Quick restart from Ferguson. Just chips it past Australia, but, well, good cover defence again from Madonna Blythe.
Yeah, it was good recognition to get the ball out wide to Webster, and again, a little skip on it, but I'd perhaps like to have seen a drive onto the circle there and try and actually have that as a shot rather than a cross, but slowly seeing New Zealand having more possession here, and the chances hopefully will come for them.
So New Zealand nil, Australia nil. 10.5 minutes left on the clock. 10.5 minutes for Australia to get all 3 points. So important for them to come away from this game with a win. They don't want to try and use up all their energy. One goal will do it. Look at them. Both sides, in fact, really struggling in the muggy midday heat. We're not quite there yet. It's just before midday local time. There, a look at circle penetrations. 10 to New Zealand, 15 to Australia. That one's come up. Dangerously has it? No. Gathered. There was no Australia player underneath it, so no danger as it came up off Charlton's stick. Naylor and Dennison. Dennison only as far as Claxton. 16-yard hit. Slight element of danger there as Claxton gathered the ball on the edge of the circle.
C5, yeah, okay.
Players taking every opportunity to get off the pitch and rehydrate. Eastham is back on, having had her right hamstring nursed by the physio. Drive down the left-hand flank by Dwyer this time. Well, credit to both defences, really. They're working hard.
Yeah, they're both really strong defences here, limiting the chances, and they're really putting their body on the line and making blocks and tackles and just getting in the faces of the attackers so they're not limiting any spaces. And little nicks like that Charleston just did is just causing frustration for the forwards. And it does get in your head after a while where you don't get any opportunities and it just becomes tighter and tighter on the game. And we resort to the long ball and the hits.
Flanagan was the advancing Australia player. The New Zealand player was not five. So Nance Corn has this shot. And it was an awkward one for Rutherford to deal with. It dropped just in front of her. A bit of a loopy shot from Nance Corn over on that left-hand flank. Now Whitelock breaks for New Zealand. Can Cox get the cross in? No, she can't. It'll be another long corner.
Yeah, Whitelock looks one of the most dangerous players in the New Zealand team. Putting energy into attacks and just... they look to have a bit more when she's certainly driving with the ball through midfield.
Well, Mark Hager has brought on young Michaela Curtis, who's come on with fresh energy, the New Zealand number 14. We haven't seen too much of her. Katie Glynn alongside her. And Anita Punt, the front line. Punt just sagging back into midfield, though, alongside Whitelock as Nance Corn gathers again. Parker up front for Australia. White stretching her legs as fast as she can to get into the circle. She's still going with this run here, White. And New Zealand have been caught snoozing at the back. White unable to gather on the baseline. That was a 50-yard run from White. Parker with the ball through, couldn't find her.
Yeah, crossfield diagonal run all the way from the far side, right inside to the left-hand baseline there. And just the pass out did her a little bit there.
Yeah, Nance Corn just putting a little bit too much weight on it as we saw Parker go to ground. In our slow-mo replay, strength to carry the tackle from Cox. Free hit conceded by Jenna. The route one shot to goal is going to be blocked. Remember, it can't go straight into the D from here as well. It can from here, though, outside the D, outside the 23. Whitelock might think about putting this in. So Australia now on the back foot with all 11 behind the ball. Parker and White, the two strikers at the front of your pitch, the highest line of defence as Parker loses her stick. Kept in by Easton. And the foul comes in from Punt. Good commitment there from Casey Easton. Well, a gritty performance from both New Zealand and Australia. Australia without their video referral, they lost that in the first half. New Zealand now elect to press high. 6 minutes left, just over 6 minutes, 10 seconds to be precise. As Australia come away with it, this is Bone on the right-hand side. Taylor ahead of her. Diagonal ball cut out by Whitelock, gives possession back to New Zealand. Now spread out wide to Cox. She's got Glynn ahead of her if she makes that lead run wide. Elects to come in and Parker hits her foot.
Yeah, Australia going for a risky run out of defence there by Kenny, but she did a great job in the end. But it was not the best idea when your fullback's on a bit of a dribble.
So again, the free hit outside. It can go straight in if Naylor wants. Dennison in support. There's some space into the D this time for New Zealand. And a brave block over on the far side. Webster watches on. Can hardly watch, in fact. It's going to be a tense game, a tense finish to this game. What does a draw do? Well, a point apiece for both sides takes Australia to 10 points. New Zealand would go to 7 points, and that would end their semi-final hopes. So a must-win game for New Zealand. Will they do anything crazy here in the final 5 minutes to go all out for that win? Certainly see in the final 2 or 3 minutes them taking their goalkeeper off and pushing everything forward. In the meantime, they're coming forward with a starting 11 and a goalkeeper. Rutherford still in goal up the other end. Hasn't had too much to do. Just that save moments ago as that ball comes in again. A little deflection helping it into the D this time as Flanagan gathers and clears the lines, but only as far as the 23.
Here again, not much space there. Looking for that deflection ball in on the 5 yard mark and almost coming off, but just didn't quite fall for Gemma Flynn there.
Flynn back against Parker, gets the ball, good restart, showing true passion here, grit, determination, tries to roll out and get into the circle and cannot get past the last line of Australian defence. Thumped upfield by Australia, and now they'll take the yards.
Yeah, Australia looking just to ease pressure there and now push players up and try and get a press on to stop New Zealand coming back at them. But they're certainly, and there we are, just turned it over, certainly looking to try and get the ball up the field more.
Jay Taylor plays that ball into Hertz, and there's so much room there. Parker open on the far side, White in front of her, and Hertz just didn't get her eyes up, I don't think. Kenny now with the ball in route one, and Parker was completely unmarked on the reverse stick. If she got down low, she could have got a touch on this.
That was an interesting tactics there. We saw Sally Rutherford, the New Zealand goalie, actually marking Parker coming out quite high there, and she realised they were overloaded, but just couldn't get the ball to her.
Punt back inside her own half, quicker than Parker. Floats that ball in to Mickelson. Good turn of pace from Mickelson now as well. Whitelock in defence and in support. Australia having to do the leg back. That leg work really starting to take its toll now. Whitelock into the circle. No, denied. Nothing, says the umpire. Under 3 minutes left to play. New Zealand have to win this game. A draw doesn't do them any favours. That's the end of their World Cup campaign as far as medals go, unless they get that win here. Dennison. Nance Korn gets possession back. One-on-one here. Nance Korn to take the win onto the baseline. Dennison back in defence. Applauded by her teammates watching on the bench.
It's also great tactics by the goalkeeper there, Rutherford. She kind of came out enough just to put her off her stride and make indecision in the head. I'm not sure what to do as they see Australia come forward again.
Yeah, Australia recognising that New Zealand have all their players committed. It's now or never for New Zealand. 2 minutes left to play. Ferguson.
And the games can come in really stretched now as they are slowly throwing players forward and trying to go for this win, New Zealand.
Again, it's Ferguson that gathers. Punt just ahead of her. And, well, another interception. This could be a counter-attack goal for New Zealand. 4-on-4. Nance Korn.
Certainly some tired players out there, and they're struggling to get back and defend.
Ends up in the goal, but it won't count. Needs to be shot from inside the circle. Naylor, confidence behind that ball. A nervy watch on from Adam Commons. 1 point will take his side to 10 points. They'll have to watch that career game nervously.
It's a great through ball there. It's just, just ran into a flat stick, and Australia tied up really well on the back there.
Well, Australia will certainly be hoping for that win for the Netherlands later today. Good step. Final minute of play now. Dennison, New Zealand have to get this down the other end. Ferguson, Whitelock ahead of her. Punt there too. There's Glynn, it goes off the end. Takes a deflection though from an Australian stick.
Nobody touched it. 16, no! No!
Oh, well, that's signaled from the other side. That's why the long corner was given.
New Zealand have been more angry because it's wasted quite a bit of their last minute. The time they're going by trying to set up whether it's a long corner or hit out.
Hurts now. Can they pinch it right at the death here, Australia? They don't mind. They'll take the point. That'll take them to 10 points. They'll have every faith that the Netherlands will beat Korea in the 4 o'clock game. That's come up off Eastham. 8 seconds to get it up the other end, and it's not going to happen for New Zealand. So their World Cup campaign over. The Australian girls celebrate. They go to 10 points with a draw here. Confident in the knowledge that their passage through to the semi-finals is safe in Netherlands' hands. For New Zealand, though, it's game over. It's the end of the road into the classification stages now. They won't be playing for a medal. It's finished 0-0. So no goals on the day. A goal the straw played out between New Zealand and Australia. Adam Commons will be happy with the point. New Zealand had to win that game. Sadly, it wasn't their day. They gave it their all in a very muggy, clammy Hague conditions.
I must have been telling you, that was the first time that I had
We'll have a little look at the highlights shortly. If you can stay with us for those. If not, come and join us again soon for the semi-final stages. Full-time score, New Zealand 0, Australia 0. What do you take from that game, Chloe?
Yeah, it was a really scrappy affair, but Australia knowing that the draw is probably a good result for them, okay? And strong enough to get them through. But you see they're a little bit angry about the decision of the umpiring of corners and retreating 5 yards. But they'll definitely be the happier team with New Zealand needing that win. But I say they know each other so well from playing a lot against each other. And it looks like the tournament hockey's taking its toll on a few of them. And it's tough out there.
Yeah, Reid Dennison just showing just how tough. But job done by the Aussie girls. Well, almost there. They'll hope that Korea don't pull out a shock defeat and thrash the Netherlands this evening. Here's how it reflects in the points table currently. Netherlands topping it, already qualified for the semi-finals. Australia there, if the Netherlands can beat Korea in the 4 o'clock game. New Zealand, sadly, in fourth place on 7 points. We can get some reaction now from Kayla Whitelock. She's pitch side.
Yes, with the Black Sticks, Skipper. Gee, that's 70 minutes of exhausting hockey, but unfortunately you haven't got the result you wanted.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we worked pretty hard, but we just couldn't execute in our attacking circle, and that's what it came to. I thought, you know, we could really take this game, but we had to be clinical in our attacking circle, and unfortunately we weren't today.
You look back on that first 20 minutes or so when you had a few chances as the moment you should have taken?
Yeah, exactly. You've got to take every chance you've got. I mean, you can see the top four teams, they do that. You see the Dutch, they do it every game. And, you know, we need to get better in that attacking circle.
So how do you attack the rest of the tournament now? You're not going to be playing for medals, but, of course, important rankings positions are there still on offer.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, we need to just keep fighting and finish the best we can now. I mean, we've just got to dig deep. You know, we let one slip early in the tournament, and that's what happens when you get in those situations. But we knew this game was always going to count.
Thanks for your time, Kyla.
Cheers. Thank you.
Fifth, the best that New Zealand can do now. Remember, bronze not so long ago in 2011, their best ever result in the Champions Trophy. Playing for medals, well, Australia will be hoping to get there. A point in the bank today. Let's get some reaction pitch side.
Yes, with Jodie Kenny here from the Australian team. Jodie, you've left yourself with a nervous afternoon, but first and foremost, it was a pretty tough game of hockey, that.
Yeah, it was definitely a tough game of hockey. I'm really proud of the girls. We really fought it out to the end. Had really good second half, which I'm happy with. We just got to put those goals away, so it's not so stressful.
Started slowly. Did you spend a bit too much energy in that game against the Netherlands a couple of days ago?
That was also a very tough game. It was the shortest turnaround that we've had, so a few tired legs out there, but we've got a few days to recover now and ready for the next game.
So what do you do this afternoon? Obviously, you've got your recovery, but you've got to keep an eye and cheer for the Orange this afternoon against Korea.
Yeah, we just got to wait and see what the result is there. I don't know about you. But, yeah, just hopefully the result goes our way and we'll find ourselves in the semis.
And if you do get there, how do you think the squad's travelling? It's been a long time since you've been in the top four at a World Cup or an Olympics.
Yeah, that's exactly right. Travelling really well. We've had a great prep. We've had really good lead-up games. Three wins, a loss and a draw. It's not a bad run-in. So we've just got to keep improving. There's a few things out there, like the finishing at the other end. So, yeah, just got to put those goals away and we'll be right.
Thanks for your time, Jodie.
Thank you.
Thanks, Jodie. Thanks to Quinton asking the questions. Winners in 1994 and 1998. Will Australia make it through to the semi-finals? Watch that game this afternoon. They'll be cheering for the Netherlands. Netherlands, if they win that game and beat Korea, will go through with Australia. Well, for the Black Sticks, there are still some more hockey to be played. Fifth, the best that they can finish in the tournament as Mark Hager gathers his side there. They'll keep going. Gave it their all today. No goals, sadly, in the game. Finished 0-0 between the two sides. But the Aussie men in action here next against India. Do stick around if you can for that one. If not, we'll see you very soon. Bye for now.